multiple punches and knees, according to cops, because he refuses an order to sit down. Officers had patted him down moments before. They knew he was unarmed, before hitting him over and over.
But they kept on, they kept on, they kept on, and they kept on assaulting him. They didn't stop until he was knocked out.
The level of force is troubling. And then they approach him, they try to force him down, and when he resists that that tension, the officers strike him several times and to get him to comply.
The local officers' union, the Mesa Police Association, tells CNN that Johnson was not compliant and physically resisted what we feel was a lawful detention.
They hogtied him. They dragged him to the elevator door.
Johnson, with no criminal record we could find, wasn't actually a suspect in this operation. The suspect was his friend there on the ground, Eric Reyes. His ex-girlfriend had called 911 after Reyes allegedly tried to break into her apartment. He was charged with disorderly conduct and possession of drug paraphernalia. CNN was unable to reach him for comment. Johnson was charged with disorderly conduct and hindering prosecution. He pleaded not guilty.
And the reason why they did that to justify their actions for beating him up.
Late yesterday, police released the officer's body cam video, but the incident happened on May 23rd, and the investigation only began May 30th, when an alarmed citizen brought the security camera video from the apartment complex to the chief, who has now changed policy regarding punches to the head and face.
Henceforth, any strikes are only authorized in situations where a person is actively fighting with us, actively taking a swing at us.
The three unnamed officers who struck Johnson and a sergeant are now paid leave. The chief, who heard the audio on the body cam, said this.
Certainly, at first glance, this looks like a mistake, and it doesn't look right, and it's my job, it's our job, to collectively investigate and find the answers to this.
Johnson's lawyer wants these officers charged, plans to sue.
He's physically hurt, he's emotionally hurt, this is going to affect him for the rest of his life.
Nick Watt, CNN, Mesa, Arizona.
Our thanks to Nick Watt for that report. The medical examiner has now confirmed Kate Spade's official cause of death was suicide by hanging. Her husband, Andy, saying in a statement his wife's apparent suicide was a complete shock to him, though he does say she has been battling personal demons. Jean Casares with more on what he said.
A spokesperson has given to CNN a statement written by Kate Spade's husband, Andy. In it, he says that his wife, Kate, was the most beautiful woman he has ever known. She was the kindest person I have ever known and my best friend for 35 years. My daughter and I are devastated by her loss and can't even begin to fathom life without her. He goes on to say that he and his wife have been living separately for the last 10 months, but he says he lives only blocks away from right here in the apartment where his wife Kate lived. He said that they share their daughter, that they have family meals together, vacations together, not officially separated, and haven't even mentioned the word divorce, that they were trying to work out their problems as best friends. He also says that his wife has fought depression and anxiety for years and was getting treatment, and that it was a shock. There was no warning that something like this would happen. While the family is still grieving, the medical examiner and New York City's police department continues their death investigation.
Jean, thank you so much for that. Her husband also asking the public to respect the privacy of their family, including their 13-year-old daughter. Andy Spade is the brother, did you know, of actor David Spade. And you probably saw this yesterday. The former SNL star paid tribute to his sister-in-law on Instagram. He posted this photo of them together. He captioned a fuzzy picture, but I love it. Kate and I during Christmas family photos. We had so much fun that day. She was sharp and quick on her feet. She could make me laugh so hard. I still can't believe it. It's a rough world out there. We will try to hang on. His brother Andy met his wife Kate in college. They were married for 24 years. Clearly a family in deep grief. Michael, send it back over to you.